All right, so let's use the debugger to step through this program, and first we need to compile it. So as you can see, I have hello2.c in this folder. It's the only file there, so I need to compile it. So I'm going to run gcc. I am going to compile with debug symbols, so that's this dash g. So if you want to use the debugger, you need to compile with debug symbols, otherwise you're not going to get as much information about the program. I want the output to be called hello2, so that's the name of the output file, and then this is the file that I want to compile, and notice that I tab completed there, so I didn't have to type out the whole file name. For files that already exist, you can just start typing the file name, and once you have enough of it that your shell can determine what file you are referring to, you can just press tab and it'll complete. So you should start learning these tricks for saving time on the command line if you're not already familiar with them. All right, so this compiles the program, so you'll notice that we now have hello2, and I can run that. Remember, it requires some parameters, so if I don't give it those parameters, then it's just going to print an error message. You'll notice at this point maybe that my terminal looks a little bit different than yours. That's because I'm using a slightly different shell and it's themed a little bit differently. So the little red X there and sort of the fancy graphics things there, that's because I'm using a different shell called Z shell, and I have it set up. These are things that are completely optional for the course. If you are interested in them, I would encourage you to come to the Unix users group or attend office hours, and I'm happy to help share some of these things, and the Unix users group talks about these things regularly. Okay, so we have the program. We're going to run it with name. So my first name is Mike, my last name is Lam, and you can see that the program runs and it says hello Mike L, which is what we wanted. Okay, so let's run this under the debugger to see what's going on underneath the hood. So I'm going to say gdb, which is the GNU debugger, and then I give it the name of the program that I want to run. It's going to print out a lot of things that we can just ignore. The main thing is that we want to set a breakpoint at main. So I'm going to say b main, so b is short for breakpoint. So this is going to say pause at the beginning of the main function. So now I want to run the program, so I can run it using the R command, which is short for run. And I need to give it the parameters that I would normally give it on the command line. So I'm going to run it with the command line parameters Mike and Lam. And as you can see, it has paused execution at the beginning of main. So we are in main. We have argc, which you can see here is equal to 3. And then argv, which is a pointer. So remember that argv is a char star star. So it is a pointer to an array of strings. So if we print out argv sub 0, we would expect this to be a string. And in fact, it is a string, and the debugger has helpfully printed out that string for us. So it is the path to the hello2 program that we're running. So you can see that it's in my home folder on stu. If we were to do this again and print out the second element in argv, that would be the Mike. So that's the first command line option. And then Lam, which is the second one. And we wouldn't want to go beyond that because we've been told that there are only 3 things in this array. So if we try to access an array, an element further out, then we'll be accessing invalid memory. And so we'll just get garbage or whatever was in memory there. Okay, so now I'm going to start stepping through the program and seeing what it does. So in takes you to the next line of the program. So here we're checking argc to see if it's not equal to 3. It is equal to 3, so we're actually going to skip over that block. Now we come to the snprintf. So we're printing into full name, which you'll remember is declared as a string or a character array. It's interesting to try to print full name at this point. And you'll notice that it's just a bunch of garbage. It's just a bunch of weird values stored in the location that we've allocated for full name. And that's because we haven't initialized it. And so we don't really have any guarantees as to what it's going to hold until we initialize it. But that's fine because we're initializing it in this line. So we're printing into full name. We're going to print a string and a character. And so as before, we can print argv sub 1, that's the first name. We can also go ahead and print argv2, which is my full last name, but that's not what we're printing into full name. We're actually printing only the first character. So in this string lam, the first character is L. And so that's how we are accessing the first character of the third string in the command line parameters. And this should make sense, right? Because argv is a char star star. So if we dereference it twice, which we're doing with the index operation, then we're going to basically erase those two levels of indirection, and what we're going to get back is just a character or a char. All right, so now we'll go, we'll keep going. So now that print has happened and we've initialized that string in memory, so we can print full name, and there is the string that will eventually be output. Now we're about to execute the printf, which is going to print this message to the screen. And so if we go to the next line, then we see the printout. So it says, hello, Mike L. And now we're going to exit success, which is now going to take us to the end of the program. And at this point, we can just quit because we know that the program is done. And so that is an example of both how all these string things work and also how to use the debugger. I think that it's going to be really, really important that you learn how to use a debugger in this course, because it lets you manipulate a program while it's running. And this is useful not only for debugging, which the name implies, but it's also very useful just for learning what's going on under the hood. And so I really do hope that you'll make an effort to learn how to use the debugger this semester, and use it both for fixing bugs and for digging around and experimenting and see what's going on under the hood.